Today in the livestock market, limit down across the board. Let's start with live cattle. That short-term demand is really weak with the restaurant closures and all the food service demand really on, you know, on a sharp decline. It's difficult to find where any kind of domestic demand or even world demand can actually come from. So there's a very big pressure put on the futures right now. So it seems like that shift higher that happened last week was really short-lived, and now we're back on the decline. There's also some concerns about some of the plant closures, and that's really from the coronavirus. Let's take a look at the feeders. They were off limit down, that heavy cash market pressure, but that really comes from those plant closures. With absenteeism, it's really difficult to move beef through the pipeline, and the process is definitely going to be slowed. That's going to back up all the supplies that we have already. A lot is really challenging at this time right now. Also, there is some concern that China will not be able to fulfill its obligation to the phase one deal. That's definitely going to weigh heavy on all of the livestock complex across the board. Hogs were also limit down. Uncertainty is weighing heavy on those futures as well. And they are really having trouble with plant closures. And we know that the supplies are huge on the pork side. And with the demand dropping at 40%, with the just news that China is trying to increase their herd quickly, all these kind of things are definitely weighing on the market. Today, the stock market was down over 500 points. Those kind of things really start to weigh heavy. It looks like even with the expansion of the limits for hogs, that they are absolutely using those expansions. And the reason that we have limits and expanded limits is for this exact reason, to try to keep a balance or something steady to stabilize these markets. But today, everybody limit down. So we're going to have expanded limits starting tomorrow.